basic phlebotomy anatomy. Phlebotomy anatomy. The three main veins commonly used during venipuncture are located in the middle of the antecubital fossa. The median cubital vein is located in the middle of the forearm, being the largest vein in the antecubital fossa, therefore making it the easiest anchor and easier to carry out venipuncture procedure. We then move out to the cephalic vein. This vein is also anchored, so a good second choice, although it can be harder to locate than the median cubital. The basilic vein. Despite being easier to locate than the cephalic vein, the basilic vein has a tendency to roll. This means it is harder to anchor. And also it is close to the artery, which must be avoided whilst obtaining a blood sample. This can cause excessive bleeding if punctured. Veins are blood vessels that carry deoxygenated blood back to the heart from the body to be reoxygenated. They also have a thin muscular wall. Low in pressure, contain valves. Veins do not pulsate and are located near the surface of the arm, hands and feet. They feel soft and springy once they are being pulsated. Arteries carry bright red oxygenated blood away from the heart to the body. They have a thicker muscular wall and high pressure. Arteries do not have valves and are located deeper within the body. Arteries pulsate and are to be avoided when taking venipuncture samples. Samples obtained from hands and feet. If all other sites are unavailable to the phlebotomist, the veins on the hands and the feet can be used. These are harder to anchor and require smaller equipment than the arms. Subsequently, bleeding from these areas is more likely to be uncomfortable for the patient. Diabetic patients should never be bled from the foot by a phlebotomist.